Seduce me.
All right, game. Okay, so seduce me.
this game is a free to play on Steam, and for this month, I am using my own Steam account and getting all this garbage on it, and now it's going to just be recommending this shit to me, and I'm not even entirely certain I can delete it from my library. This might just be a stain on my account forever.
So you guys better enjoy this, because we're getting nasty for you!
Yeah.
And as everybody knows, your Steam account, inventory, that's connected straight to your permanent record.
yeah, there's like a really angry principal going like, Frasier.
That's my last name.
Yeah, sorry, that's his last name.
Yeah, oh god.
Just beep that out.
Yeah.
It'll sound like I'm saying fuck because I start with an F.
A fictional interactive narrative. Any character resemblances to real life people are, of course, coincidental.
Oh, yeah.
Also, please know that the following game is made for a PG-16 audience. Please know that trigger warnings, abuse implied, written suits.
Oh, okay.
Alright, just audience, please know this.
Why, hello. My, aren't you a gorgeous sight? Can I be honored enough to know your name?
Who's pouring butter into my ears?
Taha already told you.
Mike.
Micah to Mike.
Clearly we should be named Poo Poo Doo Doo Skiddly Skiddly Willy Willy Willy.
I was gonna do Michael Wilson. Rich Hawk.
How about Rick Hard? like R-I-C-K and then Hard.
We should be named Spalucard.
What?
Let's pick one and do it.
Spalucard. Okay. It's our original character.
Okay.
Spooge Man.
Tyr-Lenster. Yeah, I'm Tyrion Lannister.
Yeah.
A lovely person like you. Wonderful.
Have you ever sucked a dwarf's cock?
It's pretty hard. I'm pretty tall.
Very well. This game was produced by Seraphim Entertainment under the direction of Michaela Laws and is powered by Renpy Visual Novel Engine. You'll enjoy this story.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, it is.
I know I'll enjoy it, since you'll be in it.
It's not that bad, guys.
Some nerd dude is trying to talk sexy into my ear right now, and I just have to sit there and listen.
Yeah, don't you like feeling hot chocolate butter flowing right in your ear hole? That's what it sounds like. I can smell the Magic the Gathering cards fermenting in my fucking frontal lobe.
Okay. So date month is for many things. It's for the highs
and you're stalling.
Of the fun of games like How to Fool Boyfriend and Honey Pop. Also for the lows of this shit.
Damn it. Fine. Farewell, my sweet.
Oh, yeah, somebody died!
All right, cool, somebody got shot. Oh, we're back in this.
Also, this background's from fucking Google Images. Hell yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure... Wasn't this in the Wario Denny... or Waluigi Denny Sim?
I think it was actually in the Waluigi Denny Sim.
Just some public domain thing you get...
It might as well just have a Shutterstock logo right here. Yeah. I need pictures of wood. No. Trees.
Cool, I just...
Try me, asshole!
I do want to try you, asshole.
I would like to try your asshole.
Is it still Gat Life?
please and thank you. It could be. that would be the greatest possible twist.
Smoking meth.
They're actually just having sex right now.
Crap. Missed. Let's retreat for now.
No kidding. Let's get out of here.
That's right. You better run, you stupid punks. Stay out of our territory.
It's PG-16, you know, for 16 and up. Also rape.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, 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 because that's something that 16 and up can handle. Like, why would that be? That's like R. That's a hard R.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
Well, well implied rape.
So what?
Still a hard R. Like...
Call it fate or call it coincidence, the one moment of violence turned into a chain of events I will never forget.
Can I call it Eddie Baby?
It's a moment of violence, because I never did lose the battle, but I'm feeling further from the end of war.
Yeah, man, you're like deplored and ignored.
And rarely ever self-assured.
It's true. Like, why does it seem like the ones that have everything have nothing inside?
Nothing inside!
Shout out to Streetlight Manifesto, you're my goddamn favorite.
Yeah, associate them with this video.
Victory
Good
Records
job.
As well.
Yeah, you're like if Hitler just got into art, but like as somebody who sold art. And also somebody who gave no money to the artists that they, you know.
Yeah, that's, you know what, Victory Records is very much an alternate universe, as if Hitler, like, actually
If Hitler got into painting, not painting himself, just, like, selling other people's painting, but he kept all the money.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's Victory Records. Fuck you. I hope you hear this.
Yes, I hope Victory Records hears this.
There's, like, he's just like, oh, dude, somebody's playing my favorite dating sim. Oh, they're talking shit about me? Oh, now you fucked up.
DMCA. Rain, it's been a long time since we've gotten rain around here, but it's the season for rainy weather, so it's not exactly that surprising. Personally, I love the sound of it, the way the raindrops felt, like the soft tapping of fingers. It was so soothing.
We get it, my first writing novels. Fucking lesson. You like to describe shit in the background. We know it's raining, just keep going.
I found that the rain was soft, wet, and cold.
Yeah, yeah, right? The rain was icy, like a dog face. Like fucking third
icy like a dog
shit.
Face.
Yeah.
Like
a dog's nose, specifically.
It's like Ishtar.
No, it's better than say face, because like they don't want to say nose, because they forgot how to spell it in that one instant.
Yeah.
They didn't want to go Google it or find out how to spell nose.
Yeah, look up in the dictionary.
They remembered face.
It's F-A-S-E, face.
No, this is the phase.
Fate. Could always join phase. Ever since the period right before lunch, all I could think about was doing other things in my free time. Honestly, I didn't really care much for economics. Sure, I had good grades in this class, but it was only because I read the textbook and did my assignments in class. I was not going to take this class because it was mandatory. If it were up to me, I would have taken another course. Luckily, it was my senior semester. That would mean the end of the high school's courses forever. Thank God for that. I didn't hate high school. It's just kind of mundane how the days drifted on. There's no end to it. The only thing I really enjoyed about going to school was meeting my friends.
Enough! Summarize it in 20 words or less!
It's what I was doing with high school. The start of second semester brought
Here's my essay.
The finality to it. Yeah. I had finally applied to many universities the semester prior, and I was expecting to reply somewhere in the next few months. It seemed like the start of something new, something that would change. That is, if things would change, I started the fade outside of the raindrops of the distance
like,
for now. I was sick of the class.
So you're what the fuck?
Why
Mr. Anderson.
Teacher, I have a question. Why do you look like shit? My style is way better.
Yeah, teacher, who cut off your breast? It looks like you only have one.
This is Phillip's voice raised, interrupted in my turn of thought. Just when I was thinking about class, I quickly turned my head to face the teacher. Hopefully she didn't pick me because I noticed I was spacing out.
God, like your shoulders, yes, like, backwards? Like, what is that?
I read about
oh, that's us in the corner. Okay. I thought we were just really tiny for a second. I was like, what the fuck's happening?
Next school's model.
Very good as always, Miss Anderson.
Anderson, follow me. Uh-huh.
No
doubt. So,
yep.
Kick-ass girl.
Yeah, kick-ass girl.
It's
that's kick-ass
so that's Suzu friend of ours.
I'm not sure if it's, like, too heavy-handed or if it's, like a cool way of being, like, this is your character, that, like, your character's the only one that doesn't have voice acting.
Yeah, I think that's just because they wanted to make it so you could read it out loud to yourself alone while your pants are off.
Yeah. Yeah, it's probably it. Mm-hmm. I mean, our pants are off, so...
Mm-hmm.
Like, they at least got that part right.
So, they're beside me. I heard Naomi, another one of my best friends.
She means good job.
Miss Capini.
Okay.
Oi.
Oi! Stop! Fubbing my god! Sorry, go ahead.
Care to tell me who the creators of this form...
Some guys named Black and Scholes? Fisher Black and Myron Scholes.
Very good, Miss Patterson.
Show off. Better study next time, Suzu. Be like us and study once in a while.
Damn.
Oh, damn, you just got roasted.
Slouched in her chair, and Naomi gave her a small smirk. She always pouted when Naomi showed her
That's up. The end of today's lecture. Now, let's separate into groups and work on your projects. Remember,
let's separate into groups.
You say poops or groups?
I said poops.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, man. Just, you draw joy from this game anywhere you can.
I sit in the back of the class because my top is too loose and I'm showing too much ass. Filling my brain up with knowledge, filling my pants up with fudge.
Alright, enough of that. Before I knew it, Susan and Naomi scooted their desks to align with mine, which turned into the Free Musty Fears.
Hey. I played Free Musty Mario Fears!
Free Musty Fears?
I like that a lot.
I like that a lot.
Mm. Like the way that looks.
I like the way that looks. We grouped together.
So we're like really tiny, and they're like giants to us.
Yeah.
So they're all friends.
Yes.
She's kind of a stuck up bitch a little bit.
Yeah.
She just doesn't give a fuck about anything.
She's got the tomboy and the rich girl.
Yep. Cool. Awesome. I love every second of this. We were pretty much finished with filling most of the guidelines for the project, although we did have a few something. Whatever, I'm not really reading this.
Yeah, Naomi is too kind of like really wordy.
I'm saying the words that I'm seeing, but I'm not really seeing them. She lightly tapped a pencil against her chin, staring intently at the project. So they're doing schoolwork.
Huh? Of course we did. You always go straight into the logical statistics and stuff that you can. At least, not sure.
At least not the voice.
What do you think, Tyrion Lannister?
Yeah.
I think you're all fools. It always came down to me whether or not.
Every dwarf is a bastard in his father's eyes.
Yeah, you know, that is pretty insightful there, Tyrion.
Yeah.
That's just all he says.
Yeah.
Or she says, whatever.
Look at me and what you see.
Is that
a trick question? What you see is a dwarf.
How about the dragon?
There are things that are expected of me.
Like, wait a minute.
So does Hand of the... Yeah, okay.
In this game, like, they had you name yourself Mike at first.
Micah.
But, okay. I thought it was Mike. I was like, what?
I changed it to Mike.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How about The Dragon Company? Stand by, open in Google. See. The Dragon Company.
Halt.
The Dragon Company Co. UK. Are printers based in Sheen?
No, I think they're like Kinko's. They're like a print shop.
Yeah. Yeah, printing, signs, banners, design systems. Yeah, this exists. You can't do that. There's a trademark.
Yeah, bitch.
What?
It's any totally likenesses are totally on purpose.
It's
No,
it doesn't sell print services, does it?
Yeah, we print stuff on the bubblegum. It was a really stupid idea.
But wait a minute.
Well, that's what makes them legally distinct from DragonCo.uk.
Okay, there was a like you wouldn't think that Dragon Company would do printing, right?
Oh, hell no.
Because
yeah,
I remember
really not,
this.
Yeah,
I was.
That's like a Bud K ass, like, weapon shop. Like, that's what I would expect that to have that name.
There was
like
this friend of mine I used to hang out with and this one dude was just there, and he was like classic like nerd guy. He's like, "Hey, I do computer repair," and he was like handing out business cards to everyone in the room. We were just eating tacos that day.
Yeah,
but because we like went to a sports bar to eat tacos because it was Taco Tuesday. And so he like handed us out, and it was like Dragon computer, like Shining Dragon computer repair. And it's like, Jesus, this D&D ass like nerd. it's the most unprofessional looking thing.
Yeah,
it's like that's what you name your like production company or your fucking like you make fucking weapons. Like you don't name like other things that.
Okay, cool. So Trinity Corporation. Do I need to open it again? I'm sure Trinity Corporation is a thing,
too. Let's go with that.
So I have to choose a side.
Yeah.
Who said Dragon Company?
I don't know.
It was the chick in the green shirt who doesn't give a shit about swearing in fucking class.
Alright.
Because she's, like, a badass.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to go with the...
Booyah! Dragon Company it is!
That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to run our company into the ground once we get DMCA'd super hard.
Alright, now that we've decided on a name, now what? Ignore it. It's just.
So you're left in a circle. That's the center of all. Lisette White's the popular girl.
Sure.
I think. I didn't really read it. balance of charisma and awkward, which was readily apparent when she first talked to someone. Easy to make her smile. So this is a story of a girl who cried a river and drowned the whole world.
God. Oh, yeah.
Unlike the average student, she wanted to work with the fucking schools.
Moreover, I had known her ever since I was young, but it had ultimately resulted in a rivalry that continued today. Of course my friends knew what was between us, and upon seeing me glance at her, they shifted their attention to her.
She doesn't even look like she's working, in my opinion.
What do you care? Like...
Oh, yeah, she doesn't look like she's on the clock right now?
Well, because those two know that she is your rival, so they're just trying to, like, kiss your ass for some reason.
Okay.
Maybe it's a good ass. I might guess it.
It could be a pretty good ass.
Could be a good one.
She's too much of a stuck-up priss to allow herself to look like she's actually doing work.
Okay,
fuck.
So you're down, motherfucker, put in work!
This is like a fucking Honey Pop without like the fucking like game.
The day she isn't a priss is the day I turn into you. What's that supposed to mean?
It means you're a bitch and all of you hate each other. Why are you friends?
Fail.
Whoa.
Yeah, she just like because she's two dimensional, she can like slide right past those desks without ever crashing into them.
Was the first out of the classroom, so slinging her backpack and
she fucked up. Her seat isn't even closest to the exit, and she always manages to be the first one out of the door.
Me and you both, Naomi. I wish I was fast. Gotta go fast.
No, she's not even here, so I'll just gain points.
Yeah.
Gave me a smile.
Very true.
That is true, whatever the fuck I said.
Are you coming or what?
I'm coming on it.
We heard you the first time. Not everyone has rocket boosters attached to
them. Why are they friends with the only girl who has like a fucking text box of everything you say to her right next to her? Because it's just like the way this looks, like if this was reality, it's just like, okay, so you're the only person that has this big gaudy purple thing full of words.
Every time you say something, it shows up in the box.
So yeah, it's like that.
Every time she tries to say something,
that's gotta be a stand.
Nothing comes out, and it just shows up in the box.
So you please.
The high school's happening. I've had enough. I've had enough.
Wow, their cafeteria looks like a fucking ballroom.
It does look so like a ballin' room.
Yeah, dude.
I'll take a tuna sandwich and some... I can't be tamed by the likes of that. If it's spicy, you're crazy. Hell yeah,
she likes spicy shit.
She likes tuna and she likes spicy stuff.
Oh, now I have to eat what you like?
This is a shitty friendship. Can you leave them?
I'm gonna just be my own independent thinker and not... do what they do.
And not validate either of those.
I'm gonna break the mold and show that I'm not a fucking robot and eat my mac and cheese and soda.
Yeah, that's really breaking the mold, is eating mac and cheese.
That's right. they're confined to the same rules and regulations that you are. I live my own life. I'm not a fucking sheeple. I'm not a whore of the government.
Me and all of Canada will enjoy this craft dinner and this pop.
I will... The Kraft macaroni and cheese and Coca-Cola.
Kraft dinner.
It's Cheezosaurus Rex.
Cheezosaurus Rex was the best thing ever. I always wanted to see him in the Cheetos mascot and and who else was a cheese thing? I don't remember, but just him in the Cheetos mascot fight, okay. I guess.
Naomi wants to talk about boys. She's like, no one ever talk about boys.
Because she's only in a tuna sandwich.
Boys don't exist.
They don't? Have you seen this cafeteria?
Yeah.
People don't exist.
Oh, here we go. We're getting into it now. It's not like any of us are going to get boyfriends anytime soon.
Except for right now.
Except I will.
Yeah.
We don't know that. What if one of us does get a boyfriend?
I will, put the line out there and pull one in from the sea.
I love the back in like the high school mentality of getting a boyfriend and girlfriend is kind of like getting a Pokemon.
Oh, shit.
It's like maybe when I get old enough, Professor Oak will just give me a boyfriend.
Because
yeah, well you gotta catch them all.
You have to catch them and keep them confined.
So she's Baby Mario and she's Peach.
Yes.
Baby Mario and Peach?
I don't... What?
Oh, you're a tiny... I'm a tiny Italian and you're a
Ditzy
Blonde.
Oh, okay, they're making a reference to Super Mario.
And Anderson here. Well, I guess she could land a boyfriend or girlfriend if she wants.
God. Am I Anderson? Because yeah, I'm Tyrion Lannister.
Your last name is...
Tyrion
first name is
Lannister Anderson. You
Tyrion it, Lannister yeah. of House Anderson. Wow.
She totally is where they're going with that.
Not sure I want a boyfriend yet. I want holes around my cock.
I don't want a boyfriend, I want holes around my cock.
I'll get a boyfriend. Maybe she's just not interested in a relationship, Susan.
She's really more interested in the royalty and stuff. Or whatever, I didn't really saw Game of Thrones that much, so I don't got any jokes.
Suzu Gambini! Meanest crime boss this side of Boston!
We about to throw a hit out on these succubi.
Yeah.
And these succubi. Oh, shit. Spoilers.
Oh, they're succubi.
I read the description.
Ah, shit.
I'm an open person.
I'm an open butthole.
Who knows? Time will tell.
Conversation about some fucking dumb shit. Please come to the main office immediately. Oh, bitch, you in trouble!
Looks like our plans have been cut short. The men in white coats have finally come.
Susan, oh god, that's around. Not even funny. Like, it's... like, fucking...
I can see a group of girls making that joke.
Hilariously, something did happen.
All of us are totally crazy. We should put us really in straitjackets and put us in a, paddy wagon and send us away for years and years. It's like, okay.
That's what they say after.
Yeah, they make a lot of barnyard noises right after
they just sound like horses.
Joke. Yeah.
Rolling thunder! And skies turn dark, and I can see under the black umbrella. Exact opposite of what I wanted to do. I stared at the grass beneath my feet. Monotone eulogies that floated through my ears reminded me that I was at a funeral.
Uh-oh.
It was only when the speeches ended that I was finally able to raise my head.
Harold Anderson.
Oh, dude, somebody it did. Maybe this tombstone will be your boyfriend.
My father was standing up holding a large black umbrella for our family of three. His face was emotionless. This is sad. Just gonna get over to the happy real quick.
But you know what does make you happy? The sound of rain.
Who died?
I don't know.
I'm not sure yet.
Oh, it was your grandfather.
Yeah, grandfather.
Okay.
It's a lawyer. He pulled out a few documents from his suitcase and began to read aloud its contents.
And now, I shall read Harold Anderson's last will and testament.
Only my parents are allowed to be present for my grandfather's will. I was under the strict request of his lawyer, and there's a reason why.
And to my dearest granddaughter, I give my estate, All the furniture and decor that resides within the house.
I'm in high school.
Also be given to my granddaughter.
Why do I get an estate?
Well, I mean,
you know,
I can't be trusted to own property
because your parents are already established. But your grandfather obviously knows you. You're not going anywhere in life, so
yeah.
He's just like, all right, just have this house. You can sell the fur. It's huge.
You can just live in here and fart around and just talk about dumb boys and shit and, you know, make a dating sim if you want. Whatever you want.
That's what you do when your life's going nowhere.
You can invite a couple guys over to, like, do some voice acting for you and, like, in your game and just talk about vapid bullshit.
And if you really have nothing going on, you can play dating sims with your two best friends for the internet.
Oh, yeah. You can just, like just corner off just the basement of the place.
Yeah.
And just, that's all you need.
He passed the family estate to her? Why am I not surprised?
Okay, Larry, Rohan.
Why the fuck are you mad?
Dear.
Well, did he say anything about what will become of the CEO and chairman position of the Anderson Toys Company?
Oh, they make toys?
No. Yeah. It is presumed that the vice chairman will succeed the position. Even to the bitter end, he wouldn't give in. What a stubborn old man.
I turned and my face was serious.
About the estate. Should we send her there to get used to the building?
Yes.
It'll be a good place for her to live after high school.
Are you sure we should?
Absolutely.
Why not? This would be a good experience for her.
You get a lot of experience points. Raise your charisma.
He's talking like he's a super villain.
Oh yeah,
like,
his
cadence and like
with this type of shit, there's only two things that he could be. Either a red herring for the murder that's gonna happen soon.
We'll be taking
or the murder of the of his grand of your
sure
grandfather.
Yeah.
Needs some time
or he just is the he's just the villain. That's it.
David.
So I'm gonna just...
Well, let me just get out of here real fast.
Edward just began walking, just flying back to his car sideways.
Yeah.
Don't mind him, honey. I think that your grandfather's passing really affected it.
You can go ahead of the car. I want some alone time.
Of course.
Yeah, makes sense. I'm feeling it completely empty. In charge of arranging all this, it would have been much different. It was blatantly obvious that my dad was in charge of the whole event. Who else would bury their own family the same day they pass away? Everyone knew my grandfather's love for toys, and yet the grave was a mere stone slab on the ground, void of any children's toys. My dad didn't even bother putting flowers. His disdain for my grandfather was almost pitiful. Sorry, Grandpa. Oh my god, his dad is Tywin! I tried to force out some words, and the only thing that came out was a choked sob. He told me to stay strong, but right now, the farthest from it, like that one time long ago.
Remember when things were black and white?
I've been shitting on this game the whole time. That was pretty good. That was well executed. I will give it that.
Yeah, this is that. There's like they got some shit going on.
Well, I mean, like
so the writing really isn't bad,
sweetie. It's not that bad. It's just the thing is like. A lot of these games take place in high schools, and, like, you can't write a high school without it being annoying and not fun.
Yeah.
So the second we got away from the high school, it improves in quality a lot, because now it's something you can give a shit about.
Yeah.
We laughed as we swung around like a plane. So, memories of grandfather. So dad just wasn't there for
him.
Is
that so? Well, that's okay. Daddy can come around next time. And you're here, right?
He says there's a new dessert cafe opening in town. Maybe we can
I would love to. But I've been so busy with the company these days. We're actually working on a little something. Would you like to see?
It's Reptar.
It is. Yes, it's a fucking toy.
But I feel like something's missing. You don't think you could help me out, could you?
Placed a toy in my hands with a smile, inspected carefully. It was beautifully crafted, it was a lot of work put into it.
What do you think?
I pulled the string on the back and it just started going, somebody poison the watering hole!
There's a snake in my boots.
So this weird button that just makes it start singing, and it just starts going, "You got a friend in me."
Okay, so I say the heart on his chest should light up when you hug it. It'll be like it's alive. A little nightlight before you sleep. He stroked his chin, considering my input while nodding his head. After a few moments of silent deliberation, he turned
to me. "That's a great idea. I'll get to changing it right away. You're always like my little lucky charm, dear. You always know what to add to make the perfect toy."
Because you're a child.
It's because you're actually, like, some kind of otherworldly being, and only your father and your grandfather know.
I am from the toy dimension.
He's using your powers for good.
He's, like, just straight up ripping your ideas and patenting them.
Yeah.
Yep. Let me just make money off...
And then when he died, he gave you all his worldly possessions, so...
Okay, sure.
Yeah, right? Is this like, can I profit from a child's dreams? Hell yeah, I can. Bring a child in here.
You want to make toys as well?
Making people happy is the best feeling in the world.
Don't worry too much about it. You have plenty of time to decide. Besides, you should do what makes you happy as well.
Makes sense. Daddy doesn't think much of it the same way, though.
Your father. I'm sure he just wants the best for you.
Sure about that?
Look at me.
He bent down to look me eye to eye with a serious look on his face.
As much as your father may say something that doesn't make sense now, you must remember that he's always thinking about you. He loves you. There's no doubt about that. And you need to love him just as equally.
I don't hate Daddy. I really do love him. I don't know why he's like this, though.
Your father and I have had some difficulties with each other in the past. But it's nothing that you should be concerned about.
I heard tidbits of this from my mother and various other people. The only people that had stayed were my father and grandfather. Both of them refrained from saying a word on the subject matter, but it was clear from whatever happened they set up a wall between them. It's hard, though, trying to pretend as if nothing were wrong.
However, no matter what, you have to stay strong. You're a big girl already, and, well, there'll come a day when it seems like it's you against the world. But always remember that your family and friends will be here with you. Daddy, Mommy, your friends at school, me... We'll stand together to get through it.
Yep.
With all of us, we can beat the life fibers.
Stand together, we'll fucking die together.
Well, ride together, we die together.
Do you think we are?
Yeah. Right.
Here.
And I'll never forget this moment. This second. He pointed his finger to my head, then he pointed at my chest.
So stay strong. Promise?
For a moment, he looked almost as sad, pleading. But as quickly as it had come, the expression disappeared from his face, and all the smile, and he was all smiles once again. Promise. Upon hearing that, Grandpa let out a huge burst of laughter and stood up.
Alright then, enough of that. How about I whip up some special homemade dessert?
And he like shits into it like a, no. A blender.
No. Even better, it's like 4 a.m, and he's just like making pudding. And you're Angelica. And they give you the choice. To say if you're hungry or not,
homemade dessert.
Oh, I'm not hungry
already
anymore.
In the kitchen.
The Grandpa Anderson.
I'm not what I used to be.
I used to be a otherworldly monster.
To be this,
then
like,
I took human form.
Yeah.
You willed me the very home I love to see you in. Why would you think I'd be ready to take it, especially after this? A surge of anger bubbled up within me, but I quickly swallowed it. There was no use in getting mad, especially when the person in question was no longer there. I'm sorry, it's hard to stay calm when you've left me with so many questions, especially about what happened between you and Dad. What am I doing, talking to a grave?
And about my bloodline.
As she gets a Sharingan right there.
Yeah.
And she's just like, vision. I'll get you, Itachi!
My vision. I suddenly realized
fuck
that
your
I was
butt.
Crying. My face heated up as tears fell down my cheeks. I'll bring you some flowers later. I miss you, Grandpa. I'll try my best to fulfill my promise I gave to you, even if the world might be turned against me. I left the grave, wiping my tears hastily so my parents wouldn't see. Alright, that scene? That scene was,
that was well done.
That's pretty good.
Honestly, this isn't bad.
Yeah, this game isn't that bad.
It's gonna get bad once the implied rape starts.
Oh,
bad.
Yeah. But I mean, like, it's
kind of weird to think that the same game that has a powerful scene like this is actually a fucking horrible,
It's possible they could handle it like maturely and with insight.
Yeah,
and shit.
It's pretty competently. Yes. It seems pretty competent to a degree. Like the voice acting is not terrible or anything. It's just I'm just waiting.
Other than like choosing to have anything at all happening in your high school,
yeah.
They haven't really fucked anything up.
Yeah,
it's still a visual novel, but
we've played plenty of these.
Yeah, when I'm seeing visual novels, we play a lot of the beginnings of visual novels, and I'm getting real tired of Meet Your Friend at School.
Yeah.
Real tired of that.
Do you just want to like skip a ways and see if this like gets crazy, goes off the rails?
Oh, okay.
It's about time we took off those. Go ahead. I thought I made that rather clear. The college near your grandfather's house is well known for its business program. You are planning to major in business,
fuck
yes?
Fuck you.
Right.
You're
after you
going
from high
to
school,
major
you'll just live
in
there
business,
and
business,
to and from
business,
school.
Business.
Don't be so sensitive.
This is
if
the
you're
song
like that
of
in
the
business
world,
you'll be crushed.
Adding machines and something. I gotta think of something that rhymes with that.
You will
become close.
Hand the King.
After
pretty
you
close
graduate
to the song
from
here.
College, you work at Anderson Family Toys. I have connections since I am part of the board of directors, so you will be guaranteed a spot. That is what we talked about before, yes?
Now.
Stop mumbling.
fuck you.
Don't be. Look.
Yeah, he's an asshole, and he's planning your life for you.
I'm an asshole.
I don't like your tone, young lady.
I sit in handicapped spaces
Do
watching
not
handicapped
raise your voice
people
at me.
Making handicapped faces.
What was that from?
That was from Dennis Leary's Asshole Leo Leo.
Oh, that's the... Yeah, that's right.
My
I just
brother,
remember...
So yeah, he's mad.
You sure place him upon a pedestal. Like he's some kind of venerated god or something. It makes me sick.
Maybe he is some kind of venerated god.
Yeah, it sounded like it, so...
That's... My opinions are definitely pitching towards him being like, yeah. Yeah, like a... Just like a nice guy god. He's like, I'm nice to people.
Yeah.
Want some toys, fucking children? Because I want to make you happy. Because I'm just, like, a swell guy and also a god.
Oh!
Wow, what an asshole.
Okay.
Oh...
You don't know anything! Running your mouth like somehow you know everything that went on when you're just a little girl that doesn't know how to keep her mouth shut! You did not know my father! You did not know
God.
What he was capable of.
This is actually
kind of... Yeah, he's a god.
Yeah.
Like, you did not know.
Is everything all right?
I heard someone abusing a child.
I'm not hungry. I think I'll go upstairs.
Oh, wait!
Okay.
This is actually seems like it actually is pretty interesting.
Yeah.
It's got some good drama.
Yeah.
That's a good setup and a good
I turned from screaming
there.
At the game to being pretty intrigued by it. A visual novel of all things.
Yeah.
Me. Liking you. A visual novel.
That's weird. Is this going to actually be in your Steam library forever?
No.
Find out next. I was going to.
No, we're not done yet. So, yeah. I found a game that's... I don't hate.
I found a game...
So far. So far. So far. We'll see.
You're right.
I feel like that's like every internet reviewer's like worst nightmare is finding a game they don't hate.
Yeah, yeah. Like, the entire point of Date Month is to shit all over everything.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Fart a poop.
Now
and
I'm all over. Now I'm in a position where I have no more shit to fling.
It's like being a monkey in a shit flinging contest,
though.
And you're all out of
and
shit.
I don't want you skipping any meals.
So your mom is all worried about you because she probably knows your dad's a piece of shit.
She know your
but
daddy
depends on him
shit.
For the money.
Yep.
Yeah. Tell me what's going on.
Tell her part of me was screaming to tell her that dad is done. At the same time, I knew she couldn't fix anything besides I was moving out regardless. Being silent, letting the event remain in the past.
I'll leave your food on the table if you want to eat it later.
Why don't you wrap it up so it doesn't get all gross?
Yeah.
Stick it in the fridge. I don't know why that was a nitpick. It's just like, what the fuck would you leave it on the table? Like,
put it in some saran wrap, for real.
Like, we're rich. We can fucking afford Tupperware. Just give me the fucking Tupperware and just microwave that shit later.
Strange to think she was only a few inches away from me, only separated by a single wooden door. Anything to get my mind off what just happened? Anything would be better than thinking any more about the pain still radiating from my cheek. So I'm going to move into my grandfather's house tomorrow. I should probably pack my stuff so I'd be prepared for tomorrow. Yeah, that was a good idea. I should start packing. Open the closet, rummaging through stuff. I don't have all that much. Just grabbing stuff.
This anime is going to be pretty good. I can already see the pretty boys falling from the sky, and then like a girl doing like praying with like fucking like tears come out of her eyes.
Yeah.
And then like I don't know,
the main character running at the screen,
and then like the main cast standing on a cliff, just all in profile.
Yeah,
you know, that's what I'm seeing with that.
Yeah,
it sounds like it's gonna be a pretty good
one. That was a total nod to Fallout Boy.
Yeah,
for real. I slid my phone out of the pocket and answered it. Who could it possibly be?
Hey, Anderson, you there? Is everything all right? We were worried about you, so we decided to call.
That was nice of you. Are you guys done fighting each other?
Really glad you guys called. My voice managed to come out, although it was only
a
whisper.
What happened?
No.
Slowly began to tell him about the funeral, and then told him about getting hit.
I can't begin to imagine how you must be feeling right now. I'm so sorry. Do you want us to come over right now?
No, it's okay. My dad isn't in a good mood. Could we just keep talking on the phone like this?
Of course! We'd stay on the phone until the crack of dawn. Right, Suzu?
Friends are there for you.
We're always here if you need us. After all, we wouldn't be the awesome triple threat trio without you.
Please never say that again. Anyway.
Triple threat trio?
No, triple
triad trio.
The triple triad?
Yeah, I mean... We're all
like
together.
Pussy-ass gang.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
like, we're the triple threat trio. Yeah, well, we're the fucking Latin kings. So.
Yeah, I guess you're gonna die today. Shouldn't have been selling dope in our hood.
You've gotta step up your game, Naomi.
Yeah, I cut my crack with... I don't know.
This is cut it with spicy peppers.
Hey! Yeah.
And a spicy crack.
Cool
spicy
if
crack.
Anything, I'd say you'd have to step up your game.
So not only is it just like stuff you just straight up snort and it ruins your life, it also hurts your nose.
Yep. And also, it's also spicy and makes your butthole your butthole blow out when you're done.
So they're talking about a character that had a distinctive look. They're talking about a character and a thing. Talking about how he's pretty.
It's
already 1 a.m. Sorry for keeping you up so late.
It's interesting.
I'm gonna go to sleep.
I do like that, like, outside of the looking for a boyfriend bullshit, actual, like, good TV drama's happening.
Yeah.
And, like, it really brings the boyfriend shit into perspective as being useless. Really, it's just a distraction from your shitty life. And it doesn't feel forced like every other thing we played.
Yeah.
Where they tried to, like, put drama in there and make it feel like it was the finding a boyfriend and shit was, like, a distraction from, like, the soul-crushing horror that is being an adult. But, no, it's really just, like, no, it's just about the boyfriend shit.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
it
was, so like, the drama felt really, like, shoehorned in and,
Like, always remember me and...
Yeah, and in
fucking,
like when the demon showed up in the Cena game, and he had to chase Cena Senpai.
Yeah,
down.
Yeah, that felt real shrewd-hearted.
Yeah, I mean, come
Save
on,
Sir
I've
Jonathan.
Seen it a million times.
Like fucking,
just like, where did that come from? Why did they put that in there?
It I mean, it's like the programmers
built up to that. Point.
It's like the programmers were doing the five knuckle shuffle the whole time they're doing like programming.
Yeah.
Fuck's sake!
Yeah, like. Like, wow, I did, a game called fucking Seduce Me sold me.
Yeah, didn't think. And actually, they did it. This. They succeeded in seducing me.
You seduced me. You fucking bastards.
And I can't tell anyone this because it'll sound like a crazy person.
Yeah, I will never speak of this.
Yeah, yeah. Except to you.
This doesn't leave the room, guys.
This doesn't leave the room.
It doesn't go to literally everybody in the world.
This cannot leave this YouTube video. And
well, I mean, we know you can trust you, our loyal viewers.
Oh yeah, we can
just keep this on the down low.
Yeah,
yeah, we can trust our viewers. They're not gonna share this.
Build up on my side, tightly wrap the blankets around me. Dad would make me go just for the sake of it. Because, yeah, school.
Yeah.
It's time to go to sleep. I reached up for the lamp, turn off the lights. And mine's still on the grandfather.
Well, that makes sense. I mean, that all should just happen today. It's a shitty day.
Yeah. Shook my head to try to clear the sleepiness out of me to no avail. I really didn't get any sleep last night. It's already time to wake up. Wait, school? As soon as I realized I had to go to school, I slid out of bed and looked for the vanity mirror. That's a relief. Luckily, there was barely a bruise on my cheek. You had to squint to see it.
Can you imagine having to go to school with, like, a fucked up, like, thing on your face after all that?
Like, yeah, goddamn. It's almost as if someone would be able to notice and do something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Maybe you should tell...
No, I'm just saying, like, how the story would go.
You should, but, I mean...
Well, because, like, I'm saying, like, then I mean, your friends...
Like, that's the right way to go, but, like... That's probably not something you're going to do in that situation.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm saying
that's a hard situation to be in, because
I'm saying like your friends see it and they like fucking quit talking and it just stops being about boyfriends.
Yeah.
That'd be nice.
That'd be cool.
They're like, oh shit, he hit you, and then they just like.
And it's all about like trying to get out of this bad situation, and then like then they just kind of stop talking about guys, and it's like yeah. Oh,
so yeah, everyone already heard. Condolences for my loss. That wasn't what shocked my friends.
Wait,
it was the toast
have
that's
the
still
whole
in the
whole Anderson house to yourself.
Oh my god, I hate them.
Hell, man.
That's all they took from that.
Quit being so sensitive,
somebody
Naomi.
Died.
Quit being so vulgar.
And you got beat last night.
Okay.
And they're taken away. You get a big house. Aw, dude.
Sorry, you're like, yeah, fuck off, that's really tasteless. He just died.
Yeah.
Man, come on! See? She knows about proper public taste.
And now you're making it about you.
Yeah. I know.
Your friends suck and your family sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They probably don't suck, they're just kind of brainless.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you know, when there's nothing there, it creates a vacuum, so.
Yep. True that.
Well, contrary to popular belief, in a vacuum, things from the outside are actually blown into the vacuum, not sucked. So.
Oh, so they just blow?
No, everything around them blows.
Okay. I like using, like, physics and like, stuff to explain why teenagers suck.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll get out of there as soon as possible.
Still, that's really fast. Are you going to...
Yeah, they want me out of that, out of House Lannister, because Stannis is coming.
Yeah.
Of course. Even in the comfort of my best friends, life seemed to keep testing me. What?
Hey! Don't go around shoving people like that.
Who's shoving? Somebody.
Oh, you.
Did
I strike a nerve, Capini?
Oh, you're about to get stabbed.
Oh, girl, you have talked to the wrong bitch.
Let out a laugh.
You just offended Suzu Capini. I don't know how much you value your life, but I know it can't be much, considering.
How much rigatoni you want to pump into a butthole, boss?
All the rigatoni we have.
Should we boil it or leave it hard?
It's
leave it hard and sharp. Like the wood she used to cut me with.
You're more marked for death. You and the whole Lizette family.
Yeah.
You're dead! Don't ever show your face around here! You're dead!